All of you may have seen people celebrating Chhath Puja, but do you know that Chhath Puja, an ascetic form of sun god worship, is the oldest surviving Vedic festival? In this video, we will go through the various verses of ancient Hindu scriptures like Vedas, Puranas, Ramayana and Mahabharata to know when Chhath Puja originated and how it transformed into its current form. Oldest story of Chhath Puja is from the time of creation. Manu Swayambhu was the first man on earth. King Priyavrat, son of first Manu Swayambhu, had a very beautiful wife, Malini, but had no children. Maharishi Kashyap advised him to perform a Putra Yashti Yajna to beget a son. As a result of this yajna, Queen Malini conceived and gave birth to a son, but unfortunately, the baby was born dead. King became extremely sad and was about to commit suicide. Goddess Shasti then appeared before him and blessed the child with her hand. The child came back to life. The king was very pleased with the grace of the goddess and he started worshipping the goddess Shasti on every sixth day of the new year. Now how this Shasti Devi became known as Chhatti Maiya? According to Markandeya Purana, the origin of life began from a female cell known as Prakriti. Cell divided itself into six parts. And this sixth part was the form of the mother who protected children from all ills. This sixth form of the cell is worshipped as Shasti Devi. Since six is represented as Ch in Bihar, she became known as Chhatti Maiya. Initial three letters Sas was replaced by Ch, hence Shasti Devi became Chhatti Devi. Chhatti Maiya is venerated as the benefactor and protector of children. Sun worship in Egypt and Babylonian civilization. Sun is one of the visible god in this universe that sustains entire life on earth, and so sun worship has been an integral part of not only Hinduism but also other ancient civilizations like the Babylonian and the Egyptians. These ancient hieroglyphic images of Egyptian worshipping the sun god Ra looks very similar to the way Indian devotees worship sun god during Chhath Puja. Sun god was known in Greek and Sumerian civilization as Helios and Shamash respectively. In Egypt, there was even an ancient monotheistic religion called Athenism that only worshipped the sun god. This tradition of worshipping sun god was gradually abolished as sun worship was declared as forbidden by the intolerant Islamic rulers. Sun worship in Vedas. Chhath Puja is an ancient Hindu celebration that has it mentioned in Vedas in the form of sun salutations. In Chhath Puja, Usha, one of the wife of sun god, is also worshipped along with the sun god. Usha is one of the most prominent goddesses mentioned in Rig Veda. Goddess Usha was also worshipped in other cultures as Eos by Greek, Aurora by Romans, Austin by Lithuanians and Hathor by Egyptians. Rigveda contains many hymns dedicated to sun gods with rituals similar to the ones followed in Chhath Puja. Now having covered the sun worship in Vedas, let us see the sun worship in Ramayana. Lord Rama was a Suryavanshi, meaning descendant of sun god. So both Lord Ram and Goddess Sita frequently prayed to sun god to overcome their difficulties and troubles. Before going on war against demon Ravana, Lord Ram prayed to sun god to overcome grief and for victory, success and well-being. In these verses, you can see that Lord Ram extols sun god as the lord of the universe and the embodiment of all gods including the Holy Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. He is mentioned as the giver of happiness and prosperity, the mitigator of all sufferings and the infuser of life. After the victory and subsequent arrival in Ayodhya, both Lord Ram and Goddess Sita observed fast and offered Arghya to Lord Surya in the holy month of Kartik just before his coronation ceremony, which incidentally was on the sixth day after the return to Ayodhya. Since then, worshipping sun became a traditional festival and is celebrated on sixth day after Diwali in Sita homeland Janakpur and adjoining Indian states of Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. Sita Charan temple in Munger is one of the places where Goddess Sita performed the sun worship. Story of Karna Chhath Puja from Mahabharata. Since childhood, Tolle was attracted to sun and followed the tradition of giving argya to rising and setting sun daily. Before the incident of Vastraharan, when Draupadi was brought into the courtroom of Dhritarashtra, Karna lost the control over his tongue and called her a prostitute. To repent for his sin, Karna performed severe austerities by forsaking food and water and standing in the waist-deep water of Ganga River in his kingdom Anga for 4 days. After 4 days, the gods relented and Karna was absolved of his sin. As Karna was the beloved king of Anga, which is the present times Bhagalpur and Munger district of Bihar, the subjects of Anga reiterated the rituals followed by their king Karna every year to seek benediction and absolution from Lord Sun. This explains why Chhath remained the biggest festival of Bihar and its adjoining region, while all other regions gradually abandoned the sun worship. Story of Draupadi Chhath Puja from Mahabharata. In section 3 of the Aryanka Parva of the Mahabharata, there is a mention of Yudhishthir performing the sun worship in a way similar to Chhath Puja. Pandavas, along with their consort Draupadi, in exile, lived an extremely miserable life in the forest. They ate fruits, slept on earth surface, used banana leaves, and lived hungrily for many days. Yudhishthir then approached sage Dhaumya with heavy heart and requested him for a solution to put an end to their discomforts. Sage Dhaumya advised him to worship Lord Surya in this world. Being enlightened by sage Dhaumya, Yudhishthir worshipped Lord Surya for many days. Pleased by his devotion, Lord Sun appeared in front of Yudhishthir and gifted him a magical copper vessel called Akshaya Patra that provided them unlimited food till Draupadi, the wife of the 5 Pandavas, completes her meal. This way, Pandavas came out of their troubles after worshipping Lord Surya. Later, Draupadi and the Pandavas performed the rituals of worshipping the sun god regularly to regain their lost kingdom Indraprastha. Hence, it is believed that by worshipping Lord Surya during Chhath Puja, one can come out of all pains and suffering. Krishna's son Samba was cursed with kusht, meaning leprosy. On the advice of his father, he prayed to Lord Surya, who cured him of leprosy. After this, Samba became an ardent devotee of Surya and established 12 sun temples, including the world-famous Konark Sun Temple and Multan Sun Temple. One temple was established in Kashmir and 9 others in Magad Kingdom. These temples are Devak Sun Temple in Aurangabad, Umgark Sun Temple at Umga Hill, Purniak Sun Temple in Patna, Handak Sun Temple in Nawada, Tandavak Temple at Tandava Hill in Gaya District, Balak Temple at Badgaman, and Angak Sun Temple at Angari Village. There is also a story of King of Magad Jarasandh, ancestor suffering from Kusht disease. It is said that hundreds of Brahmin came together and worshipped sun god to save their beloved king from the deadly disease. Modern science has also confirmed that sun rays of rising sun and setting sun has the power to cure several diseases, including leprosy. Conclusion. Thus, Chhath is the oldest festival being observed from the time of Satyug. Of course, the practices and rituals have changed over time, but the core belief remains the same. Chhati Maiya, along with sun gods, are worshipped for the prosperity, good health and well-being of the family.
That's it in this video. Keep watching for more such videos. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, then please like, share and comment. And don't forget to subscribe my channel.